What's up, everybody, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Now, actually, I have a question for a lot of you guys, because as an American living in Sweden, I find this extremely weird. Why is it that in the best months of the year in Sweden, June, July, and August, when the weather is super nice here, that's when everybody takes their vacation days and travels? I mean, that's mind-blowing to me, because the times of the year that I really don't want to be in Sweden, everybody is in Sweden working, it seems like. Whereas in the summer, the times where I really, really want to enjoy Sweden, that's when everybody travels abroad. Obviously, it's a lot less this year because of the whole Corona situation, and I actually canceled my summer travel plans, but actually it's made me enjoy the Swedish summer, and I feel like I've been able to appreciate the Swedish summer so much more staying here. So in this video, I want to give three of my favorite things to do in Stockholm in the summertime that you can enjoy whether you're a Swedish resident, a Stockholm resident, or somebody that's traveling to Stockholm and is looking for fun things to do. Now, with that being said, Clarion Sign Hotel here in Stockholm, it's the biggest hotel in Stockholm. They invited me and some of my friends out for a free weekend vacation, a staycation, if you will, to experience their hotel and make some content about the experience. And I gotta say, the food was really, really good. The rooms were awesome. And there was also a rooftop pool and bar, which were absolutely amazing. I had one of my friends come on Saturday night and play guitar at the rooftop bar for everybody. And then in the morning, we did morning yoga by the pool. And it was just an overall great experience. And we decided to work together on this one and offer one of you guys a free stay, just like we had at Clarion Hotel. All you have to do to be entered into this is make sure you're following my account on Instagram and the Clarion Sign Hotel account on Instagram. And both of those links are down in the description. We will randomly select one of you guys, and you can have the exact same experience that we just got. So let's jump into point number one, which is one of my favorite things to do here in Stockholm in the summertime, and that is to enjoy some rooftop bars. And there's actually a ton of great rooftop bars around the city, and there's just something about having a drink on a rooftop where you can have a view and check out the lay of the land that I just absolutely love. If you're a local, it can be a lot of fun, but also as a tourist, whenever I am touring another city, I love to go to a rooftop and check out the lay of the land so I can see kind of where everything is, all of the tourist attractions in relation to each other. So here's my three favorite rooftop bars in Stockholm. First is the one that is closest to my house, and I actually found out about this one most recently, and this is at the Blick Hotel by Nobis. This one is in Vasastan, the neighborhood in Stockholm where I live, and you've got a great view of the Norrtornet Towers. And in addition, they've got some really great drinks and the servers are friendly. Rooftop bar number two to try is Urban Deli. This rooftop bar is a little more centrally located, and it's also connected to like a deli grocery store that sells all kinds of different foods and things in the lower levels. But then if you go to the back, you can take the elevators to the top, and they've got a really great outdoor seating area and everything where you can get some nice drinks right in the middle of the city. And the third rooftop bar that I like to go to is also pretty close to Urban Deli in the same area of town, right in the middle of everything, and that is the Talk Bar. Now, the second thing that you have to do in Stockholm in the summertime for me that I really, really enjoy doing is some of the tourist attractions that they have here in Stockholm. Now, this first one was closed a little bit due to Corona, but I think they've reopened now, and this is the Vasa Museum. It's absolutely my favorite museum in Stockholm because they've got this ship that sunk hundreds of years ago in the Stockholm Harbor, and they recovered it, and it's just the whole museum is just built around this giant ship, and it's kind of like a time capsule taking you back to show you what life was like all those generations ago in Stockholm. It's very, very interesting, and just taking in how massive this ship is pretty cool. In addition, there's a ton of other great museums in this part of town, especially Djurgården. Another one to briefly mention is that if you're into music, you could check out the ABBA Museum. But now that I've lived in Sweden for 3 years now, I've seen most of the museums that Stockholm has to offer already. So one of my personal favorite touristy things to do, if you will, is to go to Gamla Stan, walk through the beautiful streets and check out the little shops and everything. And as somebody that really likes to take pictures and videos, I think that Gamla Stan is the most scenic part of all of Stockholm. All of my favorite pictures on Instagram are pretty much from Gamla Stan. Also, because there's a lot less tourists this year due to the pandemic, Gamla Stan is actually a photographer's dream, because I know for me, I like to take shots of the beautiful buildings when there's not a bunch of tourists in the picture. It just looks so much more professional. So I spent a lot of time in Gamla Stan this summer just hanging out with friends, taking nice pictures, and it's just a beautiful place to hang out. Now, the third and final thing, in my opinion, that you have to do in Stockholm in the summertime is go swimming. Now, the water in Stockholm can be pretty cold. It's not like the pool water at Clarion where they have it heated, but there's still some really, really cool places in and around Stockholm that you can go swimming. One that I went to for the first time this year was Hornsberry Strand in Kungsholmen, and I actually spent way too much time there the other day, and I think I even got a little bit sunburned. If I look really, really tan right now, that's why. But when you're at Hornsberry Strand, it almost feels like you're in like Barcelona or something, not Stockholm, because there's just a long boardwalk sort of thing with restaurants and different things, and you can jump into the water and take a dip between lying out in the sun and working on your tan. And for me, I just love being around water, especially in the summertime when we get those really hot days, and I really enjoy Hornsberry Strand. There's also some other great water activities that you can do. There's some great swimming places out on the way to Vaxholm. Vaxholm is a really, really cool summery town, which is also one of the main hubs for all the boats coming in and out from all of the islands that are in and around Stockholm. The nature around Stockholm is so beautiful, and if you haven't explored the Stockholm Archipelago, I would highly, highly recommend it. I've been extremely lucky. I have some friends that have some houses on some islands out there in the Stockholm Archipelago, and getting to spend time out there is so relaxing, it's so peaceful, and it's so beautiful. You just feel like your whole system just gets a reboot when you spend time out there. But even if you don't have a friend who has a house out there, you can always at least take a boat ride and just take in all of the beautiful nature that is right on Stockholm's doorstep. So with that being said, guys, those are my three favorite things, the must-dos of Stockholm summer. I'm curious to see what you guys have to think, if you have anything to add down in the comments section. Also, make sure you're following me and Clarion Sign on Instagram. The links are below. If you want a free staycation, I mean, who doesn't love a free staycation? It was an awesome experience. Thanks again, Clarion, for that. Make sure you subscribe. Like the video if you found this one interesting and if you liked it. And with that, I will see you guys in the next one.